Hey everyone, welcome to Camp Keyframe. And in today's video, I'm gonna show you how I created the Camp Keyframe intro, the one you just saw at the beginning of this video, of every video. Someone asked me in the comments to explain how I did this, so here you go. And I recently updated my intro, so it's a bit different than you're used to. But here we go in After Effects, and this is the thing you just saw. And on the right, I always have my content of what the video is about. And on the left, we have the information in the Camp Keyframe logo, the is it an After Effects or an Illustrator tutorial, and then the text and the timing, the how long the video takes, duration. So let's animate that. And let's just turn off this animation here. And what we have, all of these different elements, we have this big shape here. We have this smaller shape. We have the time, that's the text layer for the main title and the tutorial text layer. We have our After Effects logo. And we also, if I turn it off, turn it on here, I have an Illustrator logo and the Camp Keyframe logo. Of course, that's a composition which is already animated. And if you want to see how I animated this logo, I have another tutorial up. You can check that out as well. So let's see, let's put it on After Effects for now. And let's call this small shape and big shape. All right, and let's parent the small shape to the big shape. So if I move the big shape, then the small shape will move along with it. And I'm gonna open P for position. And then I'm gonna drag this one all the way to the left right there. And I'm gonna give that a quad out, yeah. And then put it at the beginning so that kind of pops in like that. Maybe let's make it a bit longer. Let's turn off the Camp Keyframe logo as well for now. Right, so there you go. That's the first part that slides in. And then let's animate this text here. And I think this also just slides in from the bottom. Yeah, so we're going to parent that to our small shape. So now it moves into the screen with the shape, but I also wanted to move up a bit. So I'm gonna press P to open position. And I'm gonna drag this down. Give this the same easing. I'm using Flow, by the way, plugin for quick and easy easing. Try that a bit to the left, so, and just time it right so it looks good. Oh, that's too slow. Do that again. Yeah, that's fine. All right, great. Right, then we can lock that, the time. We're done with that. Can lock the background color. And then we have this tutorial text, how to create, and then the main text and the logo. And let's see how they animate. Is that, oops. Let's see. So the text comes in from the right and the logo from the left. So the logo can P for position. And then drag that over here. Computer isn't into it today, it seems. And give it some easing. Yeah. And then these two also with P for position and click. And then I'm going to drag them over here. Let's say over here somewhere, not too far. And give them this same easing. Let's just make it fit. Yeah, and then put the tutorial like a frame later, or maybe two. So it's not, because I think here as well that the tutorial is a bit later, yeah. Like that. All right, and I'm gonna select our big shape and we're going to press Command D to duplicate it. And I'm gonna call it matte. And I'm gonna put it above our main text. And duplicate it again and put it above our tutorial text. I'm gonna select the main text and I go to track matte and put it on alpha matte. And on tutorial as well, put it on alpha matte. So that means that now that the main text and the tutorial text those shapes, those layers are only visible within this shape. So that's why now it's masked out there. Okay. Let's maybe put this at the same time. All right, now that's basically it. Now we have the Camp Keyframe logo. Let's turn that on. How is that moving into also from the left? Yeah, we can just parent that to our big shape. There you go. And then this intro scene, we can turn it on again. And that's basically it. I think. Let's see, is everything animated? Yeah, so that's it. Really easy, really fast to do. But the key here is to offset some parts. So make the tutorial and the how-to and this text, make them like one or two frames apart, which makes it a bit more interesting. So you know it. These are different shapes. Make them come from the right. Some like this one comes from the left and these shapes come from the left, but also this timing comes from the bottom. So just add multiple animations on your layers and just offset them a bit, make them a bit random and different, and then you get this cool end result. Yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you on the next tutorial. Thanks. Bye-bye.